Elon Musk, SpaceX. Jeff Bezos, Blue Origin. Richard Branson, Virgin Galactic. Larry Page, Planetary Resources. Ma Huatang, Moon Express. When you're a billionaire, you fund a space company. It's what you do. But Russian billionaire Igor Ashurbeyli is changing things up a bit. Instead of a space company, he is starting a space nation. The Space Kingdom of Asgardia was established on October 12, 2016. Along with Ashurbeyli, it was formed by an international group of researchers, engineers, lawyers, and entrepreneurs. Asgardia is a self-declared nation with three objectives. 1. To ensure permanent peace in space. 2. To ensure equal opportunities in space for all Asgardians currently residing on Earth, regardless of their earthly citizenship. And 3. To promote the welfare of the entire humankind. According to its constitution, Asgardia is the first independent, free, unitary, and social space nation, which is transethnic and secular, based on morality, fairness, peace, and the equal dignity of every human being. And it looks to the future of the infinite universe and is a kingdom. They want to explore space and exist in space, free from the tight control and restrictions of existing nations. According to Daniel Cleary of ScienceMag.org, by becoming its own nation, Asgardia can bypass the United Nations Outer Space Treaty, which gives nations the duty of overseeing any space activities undertaken from its territory, whether by government bodies, commercial companies, or nonprofit organizations. Ultimately, Asgardia aims to be recognized by the United Nations. Per the United Nations website, the process of becoming a recognized nation is as follows. 1. The state must submit an application to the Secretary General and a letter formally stating that it accepts the obligations under the Charter. 2. The Security Council considers the application. Any recommendation for admission must receive the affirmative votes of 9 of 15 members of the Council, provided none of its 5 permanent members such as China, France, Russia, the UK, and the United States have voted against the application. 3. If the Council recommends admission, the recommendation is presented to the General Assembly for consideration. A 2/3 majority vote is necessary in the Assembly for admission of a new state. And 4. The membership becomes effective the date the resolution for admission is adopted. They took a step toward this goal on November 12th when they launched the satellite Asgardia 1 into low Earth orbit. With the Asgardia 1 in orbit, Asgardia claims that it's the first nation to have all its territory in space. The satellite is a storage device that contains files from each of its citizens. You can see the files on Asgardia's website. The files are mainly photos and text, but you can also upload music and video as well. Here you can see at the time of making this video, Asgardia has over 161,000 citizens. It is the 174th ranked nation in the world in population, ahead of Kiribati at over 114,000. And behind St. Lucia at over 186,000. Asgardia has citizens from 220 different countries from around the world, from one citizen from Palau all the way to the United States with over 22,000 Asgardian citizens. Until establishing a permanent presence in space, which Asgardia plans to do in low Earth orbit and also on the moon and beyond, Asgardian citizens will be physically on the Earth, so they will be citizens in their own country at the same time be citizens of Asgardia. Professor of Space Law at Nebraska College of Law, Franz von der Dunk, says that quasi-territory such as a satellite does not fit the definition of territory in international law. Dunk says that even if Asgardia has a permanent presence in space, it will have a hard time being recognized, citing Palestine and Taiwan, who actually have territory and permanent populations, yet is not recognized as states. With Asgardia being barely a year old, we will have to wait and see how things play out, as they are still in the process of creating their government. Reading comments on the forum on their website and Facebook page, people are proud and enthusiastic about being a citizen of the first space nation. And if you believe the work of Elon Musk and Jeff Bezos, you know that access to space will become cheaper and cheaper in the years to come, and perhaps the Kingdom of Asgardia will not seem so radical 50 years from now. While I'm a loyal patriot of the United States with no desire to become a citizen of Asgardia, I find what they're doing and what they're trying to do fascinating. But I want to hear from you. What are your thoughts on Asgardia? Or are you a citizen of Asgardia? What is that like? Comment below. I hope you enjoyed your journey. If you did, please leave a like. And if you want to know how cool life will be like in the future, join the Neoscribe tribe and subscribe. I am Neoscribe, and this is the end of our journey.